So, you are looking at the project for this course. Notice how it's not responsive at all? At the ends of lessons 2, 4, and 5, you'll be challenged to improve this site's responsiveness. I want to make it super, super clear that there is no right solution to this challenge. You'll hear us repeat throughout the course that responsive design is an art, not a science. To improve your responsive design skills, you'll just have to practice. I'll be talking through the decisions we made and the steps we took to make this site responsive, and I really don't expect your answers to look anything like ours. This course is all about thinking responsively. Sure, we want you to walk away with a few new CSS tricks up your sleeves, but more importantly, I want you to walk away approaching responsive design from the right mindset. I'm recording this video now after having spent several months working with Pete on this course. Over this time, I've actually learned quite a bit. I had done some responsive work before, but I hadn't approached my sites the way that you'll be learning in a few minutes. A few weeks into filming, I decided to revamp my personal site. And this is what I came up with. Now, I know it isn't the prettiest thing in the world, but it's nicely responsive. And believe it or not, this website actually only took a few hours to build over a weekend. It wasn't too bad. What helped is that I approached responsiveness systematically from the start, instead of just as an afterthought. All of this is to say that thinking responsively is a huge help for your web development. So, are you ready to get started? Are you excited to get responsive? Let's get started.